Hello, I'm Chris Menard. If you've never created a pivot table, this is the video for you. Let's go ahead and dive in right now. So I have this Excel file running. It's only got one worksheet. A pivot table will do three things in Excel. One, it'll summarize your data. Two, it'll do calculations automatically. And three, it'll help you analyze your data. So just to get started, I've got a list of states in column E, already sorted them, California, Georgia. If I want to know what is the total purchases to date for every state, I've actually seen people do this. Come in here, they right click, they insert a blank row, come over to purchases to date, and they auto sum these numbers from the home tab, 8,023 for California. I'm going to undo. Do not do that. Make a pivot table. Before I create a pivot table, in case you've never made one, I like to take a look at my header row in row one, and I usually identify the fields that repeat, state repeats, cities within the state repeats, your source, you got multiple sources, but you still got repeating data. And the fourth field that repeats is this household type in column J. We also have two numeric fields, column H and column I, and then we have these other fields. So back to my original example, total purchases to date for every state, insert tab up in the top left, click pivot table. It picks up your worksheet. It picks up your entire range. I want to put my pivot table on a new worksheet. Take a look at the header row before I do this. Click OK. Your header row shows up on the right-hand side in the pivot table field list. Four areas to use: filters, columns, rows, and values. Check state, and by default, it always puts it in the rows. And then check purchases to date. Notice California is 8,023, but it did every state immediately. That is a great example of why I love pivot tables. It did that calculation. If for some reason it did not put your purchases to date in the values, I'm going to uncheck it. You can always drag it and drop it. And we'll look at that in our next example, dragging our fields around the different areas. Let's go ahead though and finish this one. I would encourage you, my worksheet is called Sheet 2. I'm going to double click on Sheet 2 and rename it. I like to name my pivot tables PT for pivot table. State totals. Perfect. Go back to the worksheet called Customers. Let's make another pivot table. Before we do this, let's look at what we want to do. I want the states listed. I want the cities listed below the states. I'm still going to pick on that purchases to date for my numeric field, but also want to see household type running across from left to right. We've got couple, family, and single for household type. Insert, pivot table, click OK, check state, check city, check household type, and finally check purchases to date. Take a look in the bottom right-hand corner. Make sure you have in the rows area, state, city, and household type, and you have in the values the purchases to date. Everything is actually correct right now. I'm going to zoom in just a little bit, except I actually want the household type to run from left to right. I'm going to take household type in the rows and drag it and drop it into the columns, and now I have my household types sitting over here. Couple, family, and single. Whenever you create a pivot table, if I lose city, let's say I don't want to see it, you can either uncheck city to remove it, or you can also drag it and drop it back up here. Notice the little X and let go. I'm going to check city again. When you have two items in the rows area, which I do right now, you get what is called subtotals. Look at row 5, 9, 13. Those are subtotals. I'm working in my pivot table. I have pivot table analyze and I have design. Those two tabs are called contextual tabs. Click over in column G. Those two tabs just disappeared. Click back in your pivot table. Those tabs are back up top, contextual tabs. Go to the design tab. Let's talk about those subtotals I just pointed out. Over in the far left is the layouts group. Subtotals, we got three options. Let's run through them. Do not show. No subtotals. Click it again. Show at the bottom of the group, the second icon. Now they're at the bottom. Click it again, and I'm going to put them back to the top. Matter of preference if you want your subtotals. The reason we have grand totals in column E and grand totals in row 22 is we added something to the columns area. So if I lose household type just for a second, I've still got my grand total in row 21, but they disappeared for the rows. So I'm going to pull household type, drag and drop it back into the columns, and now I have that grand total column. Next to subtotals is grand totals. Grand totals, four options. Off for the rows and columns. No grand totals. Let's go to the third one down, rows only. So it shows up in E, but it's grand totaling the rows going across. Back to grand totals, columns only. Now it's totaling up the columns down below in row 22. And rows and columns right there. Go ahead, and if you want to, rename Sheet 3, double-click it, call it PT, States, and Household. Perfect. I hope you enjoyed this video. This is part of my online Excel training. I am Chris Menard. Feel free to subscribe, ring the bell, and have a wonderful day. Thank you for your time.